that the other people wouldn't be theirs. They'd just be there usually as a public.
Anybody who's copy of these opinions, I've got them all right here.
I can email to them. The thing, the problem is though, if we do something like this and it turns out that we made the people give the donation, you guys are first in line to pay that back to the city, that'd be wrong.
Well, my theory is if the law says that's the way we do it, Jim, if the law says that's the way we do it, then we have to back up the law.
Yeah, and then you stop there. The attorney general, Jim, I was telling these people, we can't.
It was there, we can't get it on.
On that as to what is allowed and what is not.
It's
pretty vague.
It speaks in generalities. There are some things, like for instance, anything that you're allowed to make a donation, one thing, another government entity, you're allowed to make a donation to another government entity. So if a school wants to use it, you can make a donation to them. You can waive the fee for them. But private 501c3 nonprofits, you're not allowed to make donations to them, so you can't give it to any of them. There's even some opinions, some people try to say, look, we're going to let them use it because we could buy an ad in that program to advertise the city's resources. So this is the same thing as buying an ad, just in kind, let them use the building. There's a specific attorney general's opinion that says, no, you can't do that. You can't substitute buying an ad for giving them properties. They don't promote the same interest.
There was a group, it was a foundation, and they went to the legislature, and they got a special house bill done that qualified them for a donation.
Yeah, that's right.
And they didn't have to donate to them, but they put it to one.
And they made donations to that entity legal. A lot of times, there's every year in the legislature, they have a series of what's called local and private bills at the very end of the session, where all different cities and counties say, we want to donate this or that, and the legislature passes a specific law that year allowing you to donate a specific amount of money to that entity. It happens every single year. That's the way people do it. There's probably 50 of them last every year.
So based on the attorney general's opinion, does the general state attorney's motion to deny this request? Well, we don't tell the language off.
If you don't grant the request, she has to pay to go and grant. So what she's asking you to do is to give her a special benefit that I'm telling you you're not allowed to do. I don't know if you have to act. That's everybody's understanding, but you're lucky to tell the lady no, but I don't think you got to tell her no. I think the answer is no unless you tell her yes.
Well, that's a no part of the law.
Yeah.
Just like if she heard your advice from attorney, so I guess.
I mean, you can act and deny it if you want, but I'm telling you legally, you can't do this. So.
All right, that's well done.
That is actually something.
Yeah.
I don't know what they do.
somebody could have to come in here and say, what is the solution?
Right.
And then number two, we'll have to get cost on that, and I don't even know who can cost.
There's a piece of big, a big thick heavy drapery curtains across both sides.
There's an acquisition in Gainesville, Florida, named Seabine Associates. He teaches at the Florida State University. He's done many projects. Might want to get one.
He's only 500 an hour. No, just kidding.
I don't know.
I mean, I think that we have to probably get it.
We could get somebody in the sound shop.
Somebody could charge and then do something.
You know, and I've told some of these guys in the past, if you go to Parish Hall of St. Thomas, all the entire upper level is wrapped in acoustical panels, and the acoustics in there work. But they don't work here, in my opinion. It was a design flaw from Jamie and Jim. But if we pay them all the money, that's kind of the point of this time.
Well, remember, we have the mics now.
And the mics did make a difference.
They made some difference, I guess. But all that being said, you're not talking about a lot of money to put the acoustical panels up, and you're probably not looking at it. There's somebody on the line in Florida, too. That I would think you'd do it all for just a few $1,000. But the fact that we've got this new room and a $5-6 million city hall, I think we need to look at spending some money in the 12-13 budget to fix it. Really.
Okay. All right, Mr. Keys. Thank you, sir.
And Mr. Keys, my condolences, sir.
Yes, sir.
Your
the entire board and city.
Give you our condolences.
Condolences for the loss of Sheriff.
You are.
We had, Mr. Poncho reminded me that March 24th through April 1st this year is the Mississippi Coast Run Pilgrimage. The activities around here, and I doubt very seriously the town of Green is still under construction. Redo. But anyhow, keep that in mind to be able to play a part in that if you'd like. I have one other little quick thing where there's a community in Kentucky that was involved down here after Katrina, and they were devastated with the tornado. And Jerry Dew was on one of our former assistant chiefs. He's a diamond head chief now. He's spearheading a fund drive. They actually were probably trying to take cash unless you want to go out and get a prepaid car. You want a credit card, not a Walmart, but they don't have a Walmart. But we're trying to do a little collection. Whatever you guys would like to do, Charlene is taking over, going to get the period. My Sunday school class is going to do something Sunday fall. And we're waiting until probably next Monday to get here.
So if you want to go, then just get to Charlene.
Yes, you'll put it in the book. Say, okay?
Mr. Kruger.
Move to the
Don't forget the ribbon cutting.